My name is Christine Marquette, and I'm a registered and licensed dietitian with the Austin Regional Clinic, and I'm going to talk to you about how the immune system works. Our immune system is actually a very complicated system. There is a lot of detail in the immune system, so I'm going to give you a real basic overview. There is something called innate immunity, and that's basically immunity that we're born with. It means that we won't get sick in things that affect other animals. So for example, cats develop a certain type of leukemia. We're immune to that type of leukemia. We don't have to have a vaccine to become immune to it. It just doesn't affect us. So that's innate immunity. Another type of immunity is called passive immunity. And this is immunity that is actually passed on to us. So for example, when babies are being breastfed, the antibodies in their mother's milk passes on to them and actually helps them develop immunities to other viruses and bacteria. So that's a form of passive immunity. Now the other third type of immunity is the immunity that we generally have on a day-to-day basis, and it involves our body's immune system's capability to actually learn and recognize different antigens. Antigens are basically what you can think of as foreign invaders. They can be bacteria, they can be viruses. And in people who have allergies, it actually is a substance that would normally be thought of as benign, something that you wouldn't think would cause an allergic or an immune system response, but for some reason it does. So that can be things like dander, various types of pollen, even some food, and it can be very healthy food. It's just that person's immune system, for whatever reason, thinks of that particular item as an invader, as something that needs to be destroyed. So inside of our bodies, the main areas that are involved in the immune system are our lymph nodes, our thymus, our spleen, and our entire lymph system. Those are the major areas where white blood cells are formed. Our bone marrow is actually another area where white blood cells are formed. And the white blood cells are the major part of our immune system that actually attacks and destroys invaders or antigens. And it also has the ability to make various types of white blood cells that can recognize different antigens and different other actual substances in our body. It can recognize whether they are part of the body or whether they're a foreign invader. So they will tell the immune system whether it should attack that particular antigen or whether it's actually part of our body that doesn't need to be attacked. So there's a lot of different aspects that are involved in our immune system. They're affected by many different things. They're affected by the foods that we eat, the air that we breathe. Also, different medications can affect our immune system. So a lot of different aspects are involved in immunity.